oh, this doesn't look like a man-made lake or a private ski pond. I don't see any buoys. What is this place? Well, oh, he's pulling out his car, but I don't see a boat or a camper. I see a trailer behind his car.
What are we into now?
So, Matt, I'm a little confused here. You got a water ski, but you got a go-kart suit on. What's happening?
Full success in water skiing, but go-karting.
You're torn.
I'm actually going to get towed by one of the other carts for the next race.
Are you here novice?
No, tag.
Tag, which means what?
Touch and go. These are the 125 cc.
Touch and go.
And so, based on where you finished in the two heat races, you get a position for the feature, and I'm there.
You're number nine.
Third.
You're third?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because a couple other people didn't finish.
Oh.
That's all. I beat anybody. I just saw it.
Is this your life raft? Is this your life jacket, basically?
Yeah. If I do go out in front, I start to cross track, and it's near the water, I put that on.
Shock doctor.
Okay. I mean,
nice.
There's a beacon on it also.
Is that like an E-perb? Yeah, let me talk. The E-perb beacon. What's your running in here?
Mostly water.
Manual throttle.
I think that's why I'm having trouble.
Ah.
A lot of practice.
Okay.
I haven't hand throttled on anything. Okay.
Can you tell your fans a little about the engine makeup there? I mean, it looks quite retro.
Well, you're talking about the tape here?
Yeah.
Rocks.
So Matt, can you tell us, this is similar to a fin setting. What are you doing?
Adjusting air pressure.
Digital, okay.
How's the nearest
thousandth?
No.
Tenth.
Nah. Okay. Just,
okay.
I haven't hand throttled anything quite as far.
Okay. Rocks.
So Louie, what are you doing? You get ready to race? What's the pressure reading? The seating arrangement here, you have this vacant strut for the seat. What's the purpose of that? When you grow a little bit, you balloon out?
I'm not sure.
You're not sure?
Maybe you can move the seat back.
Okay. You got a little oxidation in your axle here. You gonna take care of that or no?
Yeah.
Okay, now what you running in here? Okay, here's a tube going to your gas tank. Is that just a vent? Is that all that is?
I'm not sure what that is.
What are you not sure? You get your legs wrapped around the whole afternoon. You don't know what it is? Okay. I'm thinking it's a vent.
Tell us, does this take more maintenance than your good water ski?
It does.
Okay.
But, you can hammer through all sorts of stuff. It doesn't seem to break.
Now, tell us about your apparel. Is that the latest neoprene guru top? What is it? I got the sneakers, sir, the shoes.
I think it's polyester.
Polyester.
Yeah.
Is that so you don't catch fire?
Nope.
Okay.
Nope.
No?
Just to pretend like you're not going to catch fire.
Okay.
Because real driving suits,
you don't
catch fire. This is supposed to protect me, I think, if I slide on the pavement or something.
Okay.
Like,
what's easier, fin adjustments or tinkering with one of these things?
Fin adjustment is definitely
not easier. Okay.
I'm ghetto.
Ghetto.
I don't have that. So I do this. Look. 138 degrees.
Okay.
So to get it up to temperature on a cold day like today.
Put some tape on it. Got it.
We're taping up.
Like the school bus is used to in the cold day.
Look at this. What is this stuff blowing out of your exhaust? Is that part of the fiberglass?
The muffler packing.
The packing is getting blown out, huh?
Back pressure.
Christ. This pack is getting blown out. Look at that. Oh, this is gummy. Look. Look right here. Look.
It's called durometer. All right, that's durometer. Nowhere near as tacky as loose. You can hammer through all sorts of stuff, and it doesn't seem to break.
Nowhere near as tacky. I'm going to slingshot past at the finish line and pull like I'm running 41 and just shoot out right past the boat.
Okay.
And that's how I'm going to win the race.
Let's do it. All right.
Yeah?
So you're getting ready. Touch and go class.
Let's go.
Which means you touch it and you go. Yep. I understand.